from a creature that adapts to the changing seasons to another that almost becomes one with the ocean floor. Here are 9 concealing camouflages found in nature. Today's video was requested by Christopher Castaldi. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. Number 9. Snowshoe Hare. The snowshoe hare is found in North America, primarily in boreal forests and upper montane forests. The term snowshoe is used in reference to the hare's large hind feet, which prevent it from sinking in the snow. The snowshoe hare exhibits adaptive camouflage, depending on the season. During the winter, its fur is white, enabling it to blend with the snowy surroundings. It then turns to rusty brown during the summer. Climate change has affected the hare's camouflage, as certain habitats are sometimes left without snow. Consequently, hares in some regions have adapted to staying brown during the winter. This means that there's an increased risk of them being hunted and killed, as they're no longer camouflaged. Many scientists believe that snowshoe hare populations are in danger of crashing. This would also affect other species, which rely on the hare as part of their diet. Number 8. Cuttlefish. Cuttlefish are marine mollusks, part of the same animal class as squids and octopi. One of their most distinctive features is a unique internal shell called the cuttlebone. Cuttlefish have W-shaped pupils, 8 arms and 2 tentacles, which feature suckers with teeth-like structures. They're considered to be among the most intelligent invertebrates, of which they have the largest brain-to-body size ratio. They're often described as chameleons of the sea due to their ability of rapidly changing color to communicate or as camouflage. Cuttlefish have chromatophores, which are sacs containing numerous pigment granules. Beneath the chromatophores, they have iridophores and leucophores, structures that contain reflective crystals. Cuttlefish can quickly create complex patterns to disrupt the background or to blend in, despite the fact that they can't perceive color. They're also able to change the texture of their skin, which contains circular muscles that can be seen as bumps, spikes, or flat blades. Amazingly, cuttlefish can assess their surroundings and match the colors and shape, even in nearly total darkness. Before we move on, answer this question. Which of these natural dyes is derived from the ink sac of the common cuttlefish? Is it A. Kermes, B. Sepia, C. Tyrian purple, D. Indigo? Let us know what you think in the comments section below, and stay tuned to find out the right answer. Number 7. Dead leaf mantis. Dead leaf mantis is the name attributed to various praying mantis species, usually in the Deroplatis genus, which bear a resemblance to dead leafy vegetation. Deroplatis desiccata, also known as the giant dead leaf mantis, is the largest species within the genus. Its camouflaged appearance consists of a flattened, extended thorax and intricate leaf patterns on its wings. The similarity to dead vegetation is also aided by the mantis's coloration, which varies from a pale orange-brown to dark brown. The creature's movements also support the camouflage. When disturbed, the mantis will rock gently, creating the illusion of a leaf being caught in a breeze. When threatened, it will fall to the ground where it lies motionless. Number 6. Stonefish. This creature has earned its vernacular name by how well it blends into its surroundings. Stonefish are among the world's most venomous fish, and their sting can be fatal to humans if not treated properly. They release potent neurotoxins from their needle-like dorsal fin spines, which stick up when the fish feels threatened. Their camouflage makes them resemble rocks or coral in the water, which is why they often go unnoticed by swimmers. As people inadvertently step on the fish, they get stung. The more pressure applied during the step, the more venom the stonefish will inject. People on beaches aren't safe either, as stonefish can survive for up to 24 hours on land. When taking all these factors into consideration, it's not surprising that stonefish anti-venom is the second most administered in Australia. Number 5. tiger. On their coats, the tiger owns one of the most distinctive and mesmerizing patterns in the animal kingdom. Its heavy, dense fur varies in coloration from shades of orange to brown. It also features black vertical stripes in patterns that are unique for each individual. The stripes are still visible even if the felid is shaved because of their hair follicles embedded in the skin, similar to the human 5 o'clock shadow. The tiger's unique coat acts as camouflage in the tall grass. It's especially effective in areas with strong vertical patterns of light and shade, enabling this apex predator to remain concealed while stalking its prey. There are only a few striped cat species, and it isn't known why the predominant patterns of the felid world consist of spots and rosettes. It's worth mentioning that white tigers or golden tigers aren't a separate species, as their pigmentation is the result of a mutant gene. Number 4. Tawny Frogmouth. Tawny frogmouths are true masters of disguise among Australia's native birds. These creatures bear a strong resemblance to owls because of their big heads, stocky build, and nocturnal habits. However, when it comes to camouflage, tawny frogmouths are arguably superior. During the day, they become practically invisible by perching low on a tree, often on a broken branch. They create the illusion that they're part of the branch by thrusting their heads upwards at an acute angle. Their large, broad beaks aid in emphasizing the resemblance. Tawny frogmouths also have silver-gray plumage with white, black, and brown streaks and mottles, which ensures that it seamlessly becomes part of the tree. So, which natural dye comes from the cuttlefish? If you chose B, sepia, then you were right. While these days the reddish-brown color is created artificially, it used to be obtained from the ink sac of the common cuttlefish. It was often used by artists and writers in Greco-Roman civilization. The name of the color comes from sepia, the scientific name for a genus containing the best known and most common cuttlefish species. Number 3. Chameleon. No list of camouflage masters would be complete without the chameleon. It's probably the best known creature when it comes to blending into the surrounding environment. These lizards are distinguishable by their feet, prehensile tails, and by their highly modified and rapidly extensive tongues. Their eyes are independently moving, but work in coordination when chameleons focus on prey. Most species are capable of changing their skin coloration and pattern through combinations of various colors. The skin has two layers, which control color change and thermoregulation. Up until recent years, the belief was that the mechanism for color change relied strictly on pigment-containing organs within the chameleon's skin. However, pigment movement is only one aspect of the mechanism. The lizard also has an underlayer of cells containing specialized nanocrystals. The space between the crystals can be manipulated, thus affecting which wavelengths of light are reflected and which are absorbed. So if the chameleon is relaxed, the crystals will reflect green and blue. But if it becomes tense, the crystals will reflect longer wavelengths, such as red, orange, or yellow. Chameleons will use this ability as camouflage for communication or when reacting to weather conditions. Some desert-dwelling species will become darker during the morning to absorb heat more efficiently and lighter as the day progresses. Other species, such as Smith's dwarf chameleon, practice active camouflage. This means they'll change their color depending on the type of vision of the specific predator that's threatening them. Number 2. Stick insects. Members of the Phasmatodea are commonly referred to as stick insects, walking sticks or bug sticks. They're found all over the world with the exception of Antarctica, and their populations are most abundant in the tropics and subtropics. The Phasmatodea order contains the world's longest insect, such as female Phobeticus, can be over 22 inches long. Their most recognized form of defense is their remarkable camouflage, which is manifested as a form of plant mimicry. Some species have flat, leaf-like shapes, while others have long, cylindrical bodies, which look like twigs. The bodies of some species are further modified to resemble vegetation with ridges that are similar to leaf veins, as well as bark-like or lichen-like outgrowths. Some insects might rock their bodies, mimicking the sway of vegetation in the wind. They can also resemble sticks by adopting a rigid, motionless posture, which they can maintain for a long time. Number 1. Flatfish. Flatfish enjoy a wide distribution all over the world, ranging from the Arctic to Antarctica. Some have been reported at depths of over 4,900 feet and even at the bottom of the Mariana Trench. They range in size, and some species, such as the Atlantic halibut, can be over 8 foot long and weigh almost 700 pounds. One of the most recognizable features shared by the various flatfish species is the asymmetrical placement of their eyes, which are on the same side of the head. The other is that these creatures rely on an effective form of camouflage for avoiding predators. While the side of the body without eyes is often colorless or very pale, the other is pigmented. The coloration combined with the fish's flattened shape ensures that it seemingly becomes one with the seabed. Some species are even capable of changing their pigmentation to match that of their background. Thanks for watching. Which form of camouflage from our list do you think is most effective? Let us know in the comments section below.